What's up, guys? My name's Splice Knight. Welcome back to Reflections. We haven't done this video in a long time, and it is really time to finally make it. Flash is back. It is back on the CW. If you guys are not a fan of that, that's totally fine. I understand. I don't do these videos often. I did them back when Flash, Arrow, and other shows on the CW were airing. Because I have a personal interest in them. And basically what we're going to be talking about today is kind of a sort of general review, but also a minor analysis of the first episode of Flash, what my thoughts are for the future, some possible theories that are formulating already in my head, and just some sort of like callbacks to different things. So if you guys aren't interested in this kind of content and would like me to go back to my more theory-based sort of content, don't worry, that'll be obviously back next week. Ideally, it won't be so heavy on the CW stuff. I'll still do it once in a while once I have something pertinent and relevant to talk about, but for the most part, it'll be other stuff. Anyway, if you guys want to keep up to date with that sort of stuff, you can always check out my Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. I'm active on all three of those relatively often, and I will let you guys kind of know what the gist is of things going on. So if you're interested, definitely check those out down below. And yeah, without further ado, guys, let's talk about Flash Episode 1 of Season 4. The thing about Flash Season 4 is, so far, they've been amping it up as this won't be a speedster villain. They've had three speedster villains in the past, and people are getting really tired of it. So they've changed their approach. They sort of did it before, kind of copying back to their old strategy before in Season 3. But now it seems like they are full ahead into this idea of not a speedster. And hopefully they stick with it. They don't do the Dr. Alchemy thing that they did last season, which a lot of people had an issue with, kind of revamping the same shit again. But what they have done is, I feel like this first episode, it's feeling a little weak to me. And I don't know whether that was, it felt like there wasn't a whole lot of impact and there wasn't a lot of reason for people to start doing a lot of things that essentially just undid any of the impact of the Season 3 finale, which I personally enjoyed. I thought it did some things that really broke the expected format, getting your main cast to actually leave, but they immediately undid that in the first episode, obviously. But a lot of the motivation for it seemed really the opposite of fleshed out. Why Caitlin was not Killer Frost, even though they had spent an entire season building up that she had, she was descending into Killer Frost. So that didn't make a whole lot of sense. But as the episode went on, we learned a lot of interesting stuff. However, one of the things that really pissed me off was the fact that Barry Allen going to this sort of mind freaky sort of talking through pictures sort of phase that he was going through, first of all, didn't really mean anything, at least not yet. And on top of that, he also has this issue where he's just not doing anything. And I thought it was an interesting take, because if they could have lasted that longer than just one episode and even just part of an episode, and really gone to that idea of he's not back in the same way, so you're gonna have to step up as the new Flash, Wally, or Vibe, or whoever, you gotta step up as the main hero and really take the reins. But they totally didn't do that. So they really sort of flipped the script and brought him this sort of conflict and immediately dealt with it. After his memories come back, as they did in the end of the episode, close to or in that sort of general area, it seems like he's basically just back to Season 3, end of season Barry, which just kind of felt very, like, super cop-out-y, which is annoying because I really want to see how this has affected him. They also didn't keep the hair, the beard that he had, which, I mean, as a personal beard supporter, obviously, I was a little sad about, because it shows a level of maturity in Barry in a physical way. But with that not being done, they've moved on to other ways to try to make him look more mature. He does look a lot more like Barry Allen of, what was it, 2024. So with that, it looks like they're trying to slowly visually turn him into that guy, which'll be interesting, hopefully without the tragic backstory bullshit that they were going for when they went to the future back then. But anyway, with that said, there were some things that didn't make a whole lot of sense as well. Whether it was the fact that when we finally did get some of the stuff explained, that was just sort of like, okay, why? Iris's motivation to just not bring back Barry, especially since this has kind of already happened a few times. So that kind of bothered me. It felt like the motivation for Iris was really badly developed. And they kind of tried to play it off with, after he comes out of the Speed Force, she says it was so hard to move past or move without you and everything else. I couldn't do this, I couldn't do that. And I mean, I get that to a degree, but it felt really weirdly put out. So with that in mind, I didn't feel like I could really empathize with this sort of version of reality that they were sort of trying to portray. And a lot of the motivations for how they got him out didn't make a whole lot of sense. Sisko never had this, oh, we've got an insert plot device to get Barry out. We've never explained why or how we have this, but we have it, and I'm going to use it, and I just need a little bit of help from insert another character, which for some reason has somehow gotten over her Killer Frost issues, which was never really super explained. They never delve into anything close to why. What is interesting, though, is they do have Killer Frost. She does this thing where she's Caitlin Snow, but if you piss her off in the wrong way, she snaps back to Killer Frost, like completely split personality sort of syndrome. So it's really interesting to see that play out, but I'm still kind of confused with that. One of the other things that really bothered me is it felt like the character was sort of, the character of the samurai was basically, hey, plot motivation, the character, which I feel like we're going to see a lot more of, but I feel like having watched to the end of the episode gave that plot motivation character an actual reason why it was like that, and that is actually based on season long villain Thinker, who basically is, I think, trying to push Barry Allen Flash into a corner and to understand him, whether or not that's his phase abilities, his speed, what he's learned since he got out of the Speed Force, getting him out of the Speed Force, capturing Iris in order to fully bring him up to his full Flashness, because he obviously wasn't. So it seems like he's kind of calculating a bunch of these variables. We're not really given any idea of how he's able to understand this. In the comics it's something, but it's interesting to see how they're playing this off. Hopefully they don't do the thing that they did in last season where it's Dr. Alchemy for a little bit, and then they have this surprise twist of, oh, it's Savitar, oh, there's another surprise twist, it's Barry Allen. I really hope they don't do another Speedster villain, because they've already done three, and this was something that they had already mentioned that they were going to try to avoid, is doing another Speedster villain, because people are getting real sick of it, which is another thing that CW writers tend to get a lot of flack for, is repeating the same shtick over and over again. It tends to really irritate the fans because it feels like there's not a whole lot of creative writing being done. And I really hope that this season of Flash doesn't end up like season 4 of Arrow, because that was super heavy on the romance. And as it is, we're already getting a double marriage between him and Iris and Olicity, which is just a whole nother video dealing on how that was badly developed love interests and everything else, and badly handled. But the reality is, guys, this episode had a lot to it, a lot going on, but it felt like a lot of the motivations for things were weak and very, like, when they were shown, they're very in your face. A good example was, of course, the samurai that I was talking about. So just a lot of stuff going on with what's going on, but not a whole lot of motivation. The one thing I will say is they do seem to be relatively aware of some of their issues, in they have, even in the episode, said, we didn't reveal everything, but we did answer some questions, which, I mean, to be honest, in a sense, they just sort of, like, invalidated any sort of real development from season 3 for the most part, because when Barry enters this like sort of like mind freaky sort of behavior thing where he's communicating through pictures rather than words, maybe regaining the memories of what happened to him in his time in the Speed Force, and that really builds his knowledge of events. Because I mean, what he was talking about a lot of the times in his like supposedly mad rambles was just sort of him speaking literally, in fact, sometimes lines that we've already heard before, but also lines that we've never heard before that actually in the comics would be referencing things that haven't actually happened yet, are referencing things from like a future Flash comic where Barry basically gets charged for some terrible shit that happens to Wally, and all this crazy, like, nonsensical kind of everywhere stuff. So it's really interesting to see what's gone on with that, but they sort of just say, oh hey, that was a thing, and now it's not. And he's sort of brought into this idea with, okay, we brought him back, but he's not normal. By the end of the episode, that whole shtick is completely gone, completely not remembered. So hopefully they don't use this as a continual sort of plot device, but hopefully we do get to learn about what he understood in the plot force, and we can actually bring it forward further for other things and see what goes on. That said, I'm interested to see how they interplay with Arrow now that they've got someone who's thinking of their every possible move. Maybe that's one of the ways they get around him. But I think that the Thinker in the future is basically going to use the information he compiles against the Flash and Barry and all his associates to essentially play them like a game of chess and outmaneuver them. So that's what Flash is really going to have to do. Hopefully go back to season 1 Flash, where he's got the CSI brain that we kind of all know from the comics. So hopefully he brings that back in and really gives us a sense of the old Flash that we knew from season 1, but with a larger moveset and intelligence to kind of complement it, as well his weird, like, fancy analysis that he used to do, which I would really, really love to see that again. But anyway, kind of high hopes, but I feel like the first episode definitely could have been stronger. Anyway guys, that's just my opinions. If you like this video, hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell for any new videos in the future, whether it's analysis or if it's just breaking down an episode of Flash, Arrow, Supergirl, hopefully not, and Legends of Tomorrow, where my girl Sarah Lance is kicking ass. Hopefully we'll see more of that in the future. But anyway guys, thank you so much for watching. My name is Splice Knight, and if you guys want to keep up to date when I'm not making videos, you can watch my social media, it'll be right there, and also it's Splice Knight everywhere, and it'll be in the description and all that good stuff. Anyway guys, thanks so much for watching. Sorry about the preamble at the end, but anyway, talk to you guys later. Splice out.